And get, oh boy. Oh my goodness, I did not mean to do that. Guys, I gotta say this. I didn't want to have to say this, but I have to. Something's going on. I figured you all would like the content. Unfortunately, it shows, based on the number of views the last video got, you guys are not interested. Yeah, I actually learned that, I guess, a couple of videos in. Took me a minute to figure that out, but I was asked to be a little less boring. All right, my videos, apparently when I'm explaining things, I don't get excited, I don't yell, I don't scream like some other people do. If you know my channel name, it's Civil Guy. I'm kind of just relaxed a little bit, you know. I try not to be too loud or crazy, but some of you guys like that. It's gonna take me some getting used to. If that's the level of what this channel needs to be in order for y'all to stay a little more engaged, we'll have to see if that'll work before I even get started. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and also leave a comment down below letting me know what your favorite color is. If it's green, then great. I have that behind me right now. Just let me know what things you would like to see on this channel, because I am definitely not just going to stick with 3D printing related topics. I might talk about life. Never know. Heck, and I might do a Q&A at some point in the future, but for the time being, I made an obligation to finish up this three-part, it's probably going to be a three-part series of how to build a house in 3D Builder. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Alright guys, I kind of had made a mistake. I didn't know where I last saved the file. This is where we left off last time. Now, I mentioned a couple of things. I mentioned that we need to add a bird box. We talked about hollowing out the inside because we're designing this not for an animation or a video game. This is going to be 3D printed, so we're going to actually be able to hold this model that you see on the screen right here. It's going to be in your hand. You'll be able to paint it. You'll be able to use it for, I don't know, a science experiment. You'll be able to set it on fire if you want to. I'm not condoning that. Do not play with matches. Before we even do that, we gotta get this thing done. We gotta clean it up a little bit. Actually, clean it up a lot, because we've just done basically the rough stuff. And I'm also noticing a little mistake here. It's kind of throwing me off because I don't have OCD, but you can see as I'm zooming in, we got a little issue here with this window. It's not lined up. And nobody pointed it out to me in the last video, so I'm a little upset about that, but I'll let it slide this time. But if you guys catch any mistakes in my videos, please let me know, and I will try to fix them in the next one, I guess. What I'm going to do first is insert an object. We're going to insert a cube this time. As always, we got to bring it to the front. I got to go to the bottom here, and we're going to put it in the center, just like that. I'm going to scale it by grabbing one of the corners here, make it a little bit bigger, and I want the wall thickness to be kind of thick, because I want to print this out relatively small. Bring that over to right around there. What I'm going to do now is, like I showed before, you hit edit, you subtract it, and get, okay, don't do what I just did. I made a big mistake. If I were to 3D print this out, this would obviously fail. Well, maybe not. We gotta bring this down, guys. This is too... The height of that box is a little too high, so we gotta scale this down. You can't see where the inside box is. Like, I wanna know where the ceiling begins and where the walls end. So, what I'm gonna do is click on the view button and select X-ray. That way I'll be able to actually see what's going on the inside. Alright, so right now... that's looking pretty good. I'm gonna go ahead and subtract that, so we have a hollowed out inside here. And we're gonna do the same for the garage. Scale it that way. Scale it this way. Doesn't have to be perfect. I mean, heck, this might be something you put on a keychain, you know? So it doesn't need all that detail. Let's use the wedge object. We're gonna drop that in here. We're gonna scale it to the left, scale it over to the right. raise that up again. And remember, hit view and x-ray so you can actually see what you're doing. All right, I think that's centered. That's at a good spot here. I'm gonna bring this over like this. Bring this over like this. I think that's looking pretty good. I'm gonna raise this up just a little bit. And now we're going to subtract that. If we wanted to, we could print these out separately and then glue them together later. We can even put little tabs here so that the whole thing doesn't even need to be glued. It could just snap together. Depends on whatever you feel like doing. But right now, we're just gonna keep it simple. And when we print this out, it's just gonna be printed out as one full piece. Insert another square, not square, cube. All right, so the way I would do a bird box in this video, this might be a little more intermediate for some folks, but we're just gonna go ahead and go through this because I realize just doing this the box way, it's not gonna work. One of the main reasons why is because this is gonna be extending way too far. Actually, you know what? We're gonna make this work. Instead of doing the bird boxes, I'm going to do a return. So in some houses, you'll see where there's like a mini, a miniature roof like tucked in the corner right there. That's basically what we're gonna do for this one. All right, and we're gonna do this for all sides. And I just gotta make sure this looks decent because I don't want it to look crazy. Right now, it's looking crazy. And you're just gonna work yourself all the way around the entire home. And I'm gonna fast forward for this part because this is gonna be very boring. Do we need to do it for the dormers too? Sure, why not? Bring it in. The other side's done. All right, I'll be right back. Excuse me, I'm back. All right, so it doesn't look like we did much, but we did a lot actually. You'll find out soon. So what I'm gonna do now is add the returns to the sides of the structure and also to where the garage is located. With that, what we're gonna do is copy a piece that's already built. Just gonna hit Control C and Control V, or you can go up to Object and duplicate the object again like we did before. That's a good spot right there. Control V again, get it right there. That's looking good. So I'm gonna do the same on the other side. And that's looking good. Do the same for the other side. All right, so what we're gonna do now is add our little roof section right there, a little small. Doesn't need to be elaborate. We're just gonna use a wedge just cause. Extend a little bit more this way. Not too much. So what I'm gonna use, instead of the wedge tool, I'm gonna use the pyramid. It's already done up the way we need it. And we're just gonna shrink this down just like that. It's over here. And try to fit it in this spot the best we can. I'm gonna take the pyramid and just elongate it just like that. Just like that. And guess what? Just mirror it and drag it and push it into place. There we go. We got our little returns there. We're gonna do the same for the other side, so I'm gonna copy it, group it, Control V, and just go to the other side, rotate about 90 degrees, actually 180 degrees. There we go. Zoom in, get a closer inspection of the damage. All right, so. We got everything looking good. What I'm gonna do is just change the color of everything to one solid color. So to do that, you just hit Control A, you select everything, click the paint tab, and select, what is it, color? And I don't know what that says, to paint the surface. All right, color, it has been colored gray. And you know what, I'll paint the roof. it's a little hard to see because of the shading that's associated with the software, but I think it does a pretty decent job for the most part. So this is what we have so far, guys. We have basically the whole thing almost done. We cleaned up the corners here. We cleaned up the dormers. We added a fascia, a soffit. We added some returns here for every corner. I'm gonna go ahead and stop here. This took a little bit longer than the last video, which is very surprising. I don't know why, but it took that long. Who knows? All right, so in the next video, what we're gonna do is add windows, we're gonna add a garage door, and we might also add some vents. I did mention beforehand that we might add some bricks to the wall or some shingling to the roof. We might consider that too. I wanted to do that in this video, but this video is already long enough, and chances are some of you aren't gonna watch the whole thing, and you better watch. Try to make this yourself. Heck, try to design your own house. Who knows? You might be good at it, or you might suck. With that being said, thank you guys so much for watching. Have a good one, and I'll see you in the next video.